What's going on, guys? I want to welcome you back. Toxin comes out today and he looks to supercharge the balance archetype, a deck that's already doing really good in the current meta of Marvel Snap, as you guys can see from the statistics. But the question is, can he make AP BBP good? And by that, I mean the common acronym of a pro bad balance player such as myself. And I'm going to go with a hopeful and optimistic, now maybe? Now, Toxin in Marvel Snap, if you don't know, is a 2-cost, 1 power card that's going to gain +2 power for each card that it bounces back to your hand. However, the difference between him and Beast is he's not going to reduce the cost. But he does finally give us another card with the bounce ability, which is massive. Now, what's going to be tricky and what we're going to talk about today is where do we fit him in, right? The bounce deck is a lot like Destroy if you don't know, if you don't play a lot, and that's it's very tight, right? There's not a lot of cards that you can put in. You've got the bouncers, obviously the Falcon, Beast, and now this guy in Toxin. You have cards that you need to bounce back, which we're going to cover the best to worst today. But then you've got the support cards that need to go in there, the top end card to really put the whole package together. But this is definitely going to make the whole archetype way, way more consistent, as you're always going to have an option to bounce these cards back and really take advantage of all these small cost abilities. Now, if you don't play bounce or you rarely do, something you need to know is if we compare it to sports, that's the best thing I could do growing up, played a lot of it. You have something like tennis or golf that you need to be playing every single day to make sure that you stay up to speed, because it's a tough sport and you got to keep the mechanical skills. And then you have other ones that you don't have to play as often or not practice every day, if you will. Bounce is the tennis. You got to play it consistently all the time. You're not going to go in there and expect greatness right away. But that's what I'm curious about Toxin. Does he make an average player be able to play bounce and make it competitive, right? If you don't know, you've got the basics about bounce and which cards to throw in the decks, which ones not to, what order to play them. And then you've got the big brain micro decision. Every single action has a reaction. I'm not your guy for that. But what I will tell you today is with your roster of cards, with your collection, which ones probably deserve a spot in your deck list. Now let's go ahead and talk about the MVPs of bounce, the ones that you should have in your deck, and we're going to look at the bounceable cards and then we'll look at the support cards, if you will. Right on screen, you guys see we've got Hood to bounce back multiple demons, up to 3, up to 4. I mean, you can get crazy here now with Toxin. We have Nico, who's just the world's best bounce card, being able to multiply her own stats, turn things into demons obviously, and be able to copy other cards to play even more things down. So Nico is a must here. Silver Sable, the new card. This is just a very solid stat card alongside Rocky Raccoon. Both of these are incredible to get bounce back and get very high and vertical in lanes. And then you've got the cards that are a little bit less, right? Like Iceman, I think, is pretty much belonging with these guys. I mean, just being able to destroy your opponent's combos and bouncing it back several times is massive. Kate Bishop is another card right there on the cusp that can be in a lot of decks as well, but probably not going to as much with the cuts that we're going to have to make. Shadow King, a little bit scary. You have a lot of cards that are obviously going up in stats like Rocket and Sable and even things like Nico. However, you know, obviously Shadow King, very good card to play down. And even that doesn't cover it all. You've got higher cost cards that we're going to cover. You got Hawkeye, things like that. You have mill options, right? Yondu and whatnot to keep on playing them. The small mover package of, you know, Iron Fist, Ghost Spider, that's its own thing as well. So there's a lot of flexibility in a single archetype compared to other ones, but there's not a lot of flexibility or room to mess with in the deck. Now, we talked about the cards you want to bounce back. Let's talk about the support cards, and these are almost just as important and which makes this whole conversation about which one gets the cut that much harder. Now, when we talk about the best bounce MVPs, the supports here to help out your bounceable cards outside, you know, Beast, Falcon, and now Toxin, you've got kind of the staple ones now, right? Like Bishop is in most of those decks. You have Agent Venom as well, just being an incredible bounce card. You have Black Swan to make your cards free. Now with Activate, obviously really good. Mysterio is going to pair up with both Bishop and Hitmonkey, another card that can support the archetype. You have cards that can really take you over the top and multiply what you've been doing. So Sage is an excellent example here. Iron Man, you've got Sasquatch and Mockingbird to pair up with the Mysterio. You can go Wiccan to go extra energy. Angela, Hope Summers, even the Havoc route if you really want to go crazy. And so which one of these do you include, right? And it comes down to what you have in your collection and personal preference. I'm probably going to say out of these, I feel like Toxin replaces what Bishop does in these decks. It's tough to cut him because of Mysterio and how that works with Agent Venom, but someone's gonna have to get cut, right? You can't include everybody. Black Swan is also on the list. Both her and Bishop are standard now in these bounce decks with Agent Venom and Mysterio. And so we're going to have to look just how many balance cards that you need, because I do think Falcon, Beast, and Toxin are all played to make sure that you can balance your cards. And you guys are going to see kind of what I put together in today's deck, what I think is going to perform really well. But before we get to that, let's talk about my star ratings after play the card. Do I think he's any good? I do, but what do I think about him in general? Now, starting off looking at the competitive tier, I kind of like Scorn here. This is a tough one to rank because we're talking about really just one main archetype. But, you know, obviously, if Beast came out today, how would we rank Beast? Somewhat similar here, we have Toxin, who not only has just good stats, but most importantly, he gives you the ability to balance. And so, or the balance archetype, if that's something you play, he's a 5-star, right? He's a very good card here. You know, I give him like a 4.5 just to take a little bit off the top here. But, you know, because Falcon and Beast did work before him. But this is giving you much more dependability in your draw to ensure that you have a way to bounce your cards back. Obviously, a very good thing for the archetype. This is no question a good card. Now, the fun factor depends on how much you like playing bounce, but I do think this adds an extra element to both strategy and honestly fun when it comes to the archetype. So definitely a card that I think is pretty damn fun. I give it like a 3.5 myself. Probably would give it way more than that if I wasn't stupid to the archetype. Flexibility, like a 2. You know, a little bit of anti-clog here and there. You can maybe work it into a couple decks. You know, we're not doing the whole century thing anymore, but I do think he's a little flexible. But not too much, right? Obviously, balance is his main home. 2-star feels about right in this category. And last but not least, we have stability. And I'm going to be honest, I'm not convinced that this is going to be a card that doesn't get nerfed. And you know, that's mainly because I feel like balance is one of those archetypes that the devs want to see in the player's hands. And if you look at the stats, you look at bouncing things back a ton and combining this with Nico and Okapi and Beast, all the crazy things that can happen on top of the archetype already doing really well. I don't know what to rank this. I think he could definitely see, he's got a lot of knobs, as we like to call it, that they can adjust. So I'm not sold here, but as long as he keeps his bounce ability, he's probably fine. Alrighty guys, let's go ahead and dive into today's decks. You can tell I'm really cooking in the name department here with Monkey Bounce. And you guys are going to see a very similar list that I have for you today with a couple of changes. And that's mainly our over-the-top options, the finishers, if you will. Obviously, the main objective of the deck is to build up the small cards like Silver Sable, Rocket, get as many demons as possible, get Nico built up or doing her thing, and then using one of your bounce options, whether that's Toxin and you got 3 cards down, Falcon or Beast, you know, you're not going to get them all. And so it's going to be a little bit of a, you know, play what you can. And Toxin is one that I'm going to aim to play as much as possible today. Obviously, comboing all of this with Black Swan activating into Hitmonkey for a last turn pop off is the main play. Things like Mysterio get a huge boost for Hitmonkey, but also via Agent Venom. You're going to see Agent Venom in all of these decks. And for that matter, if you don't have Silver Sable, if you didn't get the Season Pass, replace these cards with the ones that I talked about in the flexibility department earlier. But yep, play these cards in one lane, get them bounced back, start feeding them up, get your support cards on the board like Black Swan, and then finish and close up early with Sage and Hitmonkey. Now you can see I'm still cooking in the name department, just one name change in Wolf Bounce instead of Monkey Bounce, and that's again because our over-the-top options are going to change ever so slightly. I got Werewolf by Night and Iron Man on this build because, you know, balance is already hard enough. Why not make it even harder? For me, it's tough not to play Agent Venom with Iron Man. I just love the combination. It's crazy to have that double value. Usually you can win one lane with your built-up Rockets and Silver Sable, and Iron Man can simply win the other. I feel like this has a perfect breed between both bounce cards, support cards, and then, you know, the cards to get the bouncing going. And so this is probably going to be my favorite of today, although obviously the hardest if I had to take a guess. And then last but not least, I've not played a ton of it, but Wiccan Bounce is definitely something you should try if you do have Wiccan. You have so many cheap cards with ones and twos that's easy to get Wiccan down for the extra energy to bounce even more with Toxin and Beast. Maybe get the infinity loop thing going on here. And then we've got Hitmonkey combined with all of this energy to take him well over the top, right? We've got so many ones. We have the Iceman that we can finally tech in here because it feels right. Collector should go up in massive value because of how much we can bounce with the extra energy. And then, of course, Agent Venom to kind of tie in everything together. Super excited about this deck. I'm interested to see how, you know, consistent it is, and it's a little bit different than the other two I talked about earlier. So yep, all in all, looking at all 3 decks, it's just going to take some time to get used to how they play, see how the play lines work out, and obviously I'm going to show you that in today's battles. And that's pretty much everything you need to know. Obviously, you guys are going to learn best by just watching balance, playing it yourself, so we're going to go ahead and hop into some matches. Again, guys, just want to say appreciate you guys as a community. You guys mean so much to me just with what everything we've accomplished in about 2 years here on the channel that it's been active now. And yeah, means a lot. If you haven't already, go ahead and join the community. Subscribe down below. Trying to get to 150K before we hop into these matches. Well, not before that, just by the end of the year. But that'd be cool. Anyway, let's hop in. Alrighty, so wow, we love the Wakan Embassy boost. We have Rocket Raccoon. We have a Nico to draw into the deck into Agent Venom, which feels sad, but also insanely powerful. So that's what we're going to go with, is killing Agent Venom. That is a 2-6, but getting access to the rest of the fours in the deck and really just opening us up to whatever we want to do. Alright, so we're playing Potential Zoo. Deep Space, I think, is actually just fine with me, because we can end up playing demons and whatnot in there, playing just our high ones. Okay, we got Hawkeye. There's the Falcon. There's the Toxin. Hello. Okay, alrighty. What do we want to do with this hand? We could, this is where we can do some of the Toxin stuff. We get two back. We still draw. We could just Falcon that to make him bigger, but I like the idea of bouncing him, and so this is probably the play I'll go with. Oh, he didn't play right. Bummer, bummer. It's okay, though. All good. We're just going to build up the Toxin instead. A 2-8, we'll take it. Copy of a card is insanity. Oh, my God. I mean, we can't bounce back yet, but that's fine, right? What do we want to copy here? The Sage, I would imagine. Yeah, this just wins it, I feel like. The Sage here is such a huge play. Black Swan is obviously massive to play now so that we can activate her in time, but we're just going to probably bounce stuff back anyway. Short of this guy having a Cosmo, I feel pretty good. Keep in mind, Deep Space is going to be tough to beat with a Zoo deck, but it does limit where he can put something like Gilgamesh. And look at that, just a 12 Sage coming right back to us. We'll take it. So we can bounce this back, but we have to play a lot of cards, right? So if we did this, we're getting it all. This is a tough play to ask for. But he has to play in this lane next. We have this. These three come back. We don't draw. It'd be Hitmonkey or Hood, which I think is fine. And we get these three back. Yeah, to me, this seems great. I mean, we're going to have to play Sage and Toxin have a lot of power. So we're going to have to figure that out. But that might be worth it. Or we just don't play him and we play the Sage. And we hope for the Hitmonkey. That's option number two. I think I like that a bit better. Like, these two get so high at this point. Or even better, we just do this. And that way we draw, we get these two. Okay, this is the route I'm going to go. He doesn't play into that lane. That's insane to me. That goes to a 28, which we can beat, assuming he has like a blue Marvel as well, and that there's the Marvel boy. We got to be a little careful. We for sure going to get value out of the Rocket now. And if we get Hitmonkey, I think it's GG. Okay, I think it's GG. Because I think we just Sage here, go way over the top, let him have the middle, and hit him with this. I mean, this is such a huge, a pretty big play. Pretty massive play. We could have thrown Sage and done something in Deep Space, but really no need to here. He goes Mockingbird, Dazzler, which does go pretty high over the top. Doesn't even play the blue Marvel. Sage going to 36 power worth of Sage, I would say, is what some would consider absolutely insane. Sable going off the map into the last Hitmonkey. Man, this thing gets high. And it's tough. It's tough to beat Zoo decks, but man, is this the deck to do it with. I love the Hitmonkey version way more than I thought I would. I think that Werewolf by Night's probably better. But this is easier. All right, so we start out with Nico this time. A Black Swan in the Hood. And Silver Sable. Let's start with the Sable. We like that. Look at that. You know it's a new card day when you see the same decks. Westview, okay. And there he is, Toxin. Although he did get hit a little bit, but that's okay. So we can, well, we got a couple things we can do. This is obviously not bad, but we need to bounce that back. So we could make Toxin into a demon, which I don't absolutely hate. The demon thing's kind of nice. This is kind of a tough decision here. I'm going to go with Black Swan for now. Let's just see what our next play is. This is why balance stresses me out. There's so many plays we could have done there. Okay, we have Sage into... All right, okay. Do I want Sage back? That's interesting. Probably not. Thing is I don't really like any of these other cards here. I guess we can do something like this just with the two. I'm not in love with it, though. Not crazy about it. We could just go with Sage and bounce here back. Maybe I just play the Sage. This feels off big time. Don't judge me. This does feel off, though. Especially because, well, we're going to go up no power at all. Good God. All right, don't judge yet. We're okay. Nobody... Okay, you can judge now. You can... Okay, you guys get... You can judge now. Don't worry about it. All right. Well, let's go ahead and... I think we're going to go Hood into Nico into Toxin here. And then we're going to activate this. And then this will give us another Toxin with the power already. So look at that. Everything works out. Kind of weird. Especially because I think I'm going to pick this card up before she activates. Because of the way that I did it, which is so funny to me. Wonderful. Okay, but we did make a copy of it, so there's that. Yeah, but we didn't activate it. God, that's hilarious. So now we literally can't use her, really? Okay, let's see. We have to play right side. We can get the Toxin back yet again. We know he's going to play there. I don't hate this. This seems pretty good, actually. Yeah, let's do this. This is me. Like, I feel like every play I'm making has a question mark at the end of it. That's fine. We just don't pick up the Toxin. And then the only thing taking the hit is that negative. I think, honestly, best case scenario. I mean, whatever. We got the Rocket back. Okay. Well. And we destroy two. Okay. Let's go Demon, Demon, Rocket. Dude, and then we have like no power. This is going to 17 over there. Top it off with the two. I don't love this play, but I don't think it loses. I think we're going too... We're stretched out too good for us to lose here. Yeah, we're good. Okay. Dude, that was... See, listen. You can suck too and also still win. Double Toxins with the copy is so sick. We didn't even play Falcon or Beast. The Toxins just did what they needed to do. Alrighty, guys. We have the Sandbar. We have Hood, Black Swan. Pretty good opening play here. This, unfortunately, makes Demon cost one more. So that's unfortunate. But let's go ahead and play this down now. We have a Mount Vesuvius, which we like, and an Agent Venom on turn two. What is not to love? We do have Black Swan we can play now. Definitely always want to play this down as soon as possible. We'll throw him down in the middle. Warrior Falls. Okay, okay. And there, look at that Silver Sable, 1/4. Absolute ridiculousness. We could play this down into Falcon. That's definitely something now. I think getting the Black Swan out is probably a good idea. This defeats the weaker ones. She's a 1/6. Not half bad, that's for sure. We'll go in and play her here, though, obviously, to get the bounce things going on. Juggernaut into... kind of tough. Okay, so we're going to need to make sure that we... We got to make sure that we protect Black Swan or activate her as soon as possible. Or just change her location. Interesting. Because here's the deal. We do a lot here. I'm thinking that we'll do this right here. This is going to change this location. We get these two up. They don't cost any less, but that's fine. We can make them cost less next time. And I'd probably snap here too. But we can also just play them for free if we want to go that route. So I guess we maybe should have activated her now, but whatever. Because now what we can do is if we do get Toxin, which we don't have him yet. Okay, we have Sage. Then we could activate her now and go off that. Oh, wow. With Nico's copy, dude, I think just this into this, into that, into this is a pretty ridiculous. Like, this is a really... I mean, if we didn't have the sandbar, I would have changed things up, but God, this is insane. Okay, look at this, man. We're going to have an 8 that we caught. Oh, this is so good. I just love bounce. I love it, but I hate it. It's a love-hate. All right, 0-8. Okay, this is obviously fantastic. And Hitmonkey. So we didn't get Toxin. That's fine. Again, you know, we're not going to get it every match. But what we do get is a Mount Vesuvius, so he can't retreat. So we're going to really, really just decimate this guy, man. I'm thinking that this could be Ultron. So just in case, this is where we're going to put the Hitmonkey. We'll put all these right here. I suppose we could actually finish off with the Sage there. And this is how we are going to finish. This is such a strong, strong freaking thing here. Alrighty. Not worried there. And he's got a Bishop, which he didn't even play. Why? Oh, because he wanted the Mystique. I don't know. But what I do know is that was an absolute slaughtering with just a couple Silver Sables that are 110 a pop. Sage over the top getting a 12 power. You got the Nico. And we just put out so much power. And that's what's just dangerous, man. Dangerous about the card. 37, 16, 18 with no Toxin. Feels pretty good. Alrighty, we do have Toxin in the starting hand. Nico into Silver Sable. So I really like what we have. This is not the worst Nico to play down early either. So I think we're going to do just that. And we're gonna compete on Hala here. Just because we can. Well, Shuri's Lab is really good. Let's play this down now. Okay, we have the Angela. Hood is massive here. We do have a 5-4 Iron Man. Already feel invincible, not gonna lie. We could do this now for not a crazy play, but just good enough, if that makes sense. Get these guys again. Might wanna do it again. I mean, honestly though, bouncing back this Venom and playing him for double is probably the play, man. Let's do that. Because he's just gonna win a lane. I could have snapped it if I wanted to. He's just going to win a lane by himself, a massive Agent Venom. I mean, Shuri's Lab is just cheat codes for the deck we're playing, quite honestly. And now, if we don't draw a rock, we can make all the rocks 4 power. Yeah, look at this. This is that's pretty sweet. We can play him now just to ensure we get that. And we've got the 2. If he kills this, it's not the end of the world. I think I'd rather just play Black Swan. Yeah, we'll play Black Swan here. This is, by the way, a definite snap if you guys are in my position here. What's great is, as the Sable just hit that, we're able just to do this. Turns it back to 4. No big deal. No big deal. Okay, Black Swan going down now. Hala survives somehow. There's the rock. That's okay, though. Playing just Iron Man is probably pretty ideal at the moment. The rocks are worth +3. These rocks are actually the biggest gift he could give us. I might put this over here left to scare him off. We could just play that probably middle too, though, if I'm being... Yeah, we're going to go for the all three lanes approach just to make sure he has no idea what to do. We have Sable and Rock for free and the Sage. We're going to pop off. He probably has like a Shang-Chi, maybe. He's going to have to get out of here, man. I just don't see us losing this. Okay, so we're going to go Sable into Rock, into Sage, into Rocket here. Or do we go Rocket? Probably Rocket here, because he's going to play here to try to get over the top, but he's not going to be able to. Here we go. I'd be shocked if he stayed, but let's see if he does. He's going to avoid Hala. He's not playing Hala. No one plays an Iron Man lane. No way. No shot there. He's probably going to retreat. I mean, he's doing the math. He's like, man, I would have to. Nope, he's going. Okay. 1, 2. We've got a lot of different power lines. Everything's unique. 29, that's going to be tough to beat. He might go like, he might go Mystique here or something. Okay. But if we went Mystique here, which didn't do anything, what is he doing here? Cosmo. Okay. Well, with priority, that would have been okay. Yeah, man, that was really good against a pretty strong deck. Played it out, I think, as well as we could. Well, this is just a bouncer's dream. We have a copy of a card. We have a lot going on here. So we're definitely going to just play Nico into Sable and or Rocket. And then we have Agent Venom, too. I guess the only weird thing is we can't Agent Venom this turn, which I think is probably fine because we have the copy. We got a just a regular Patriot Gamer here. The hell? Oh, it's Airship. Okay. Ooh, cloning vats. So we can make two copies of this? That's kind of cool. I don't think we do. I think this is probably the play instead and get a copy of that. Wow. Okay, he's got the Quinjet. He's got the Quinjet, guys. I think we can beat this over the top, though, as long as he doesn't have a Killmonger. This limits both him and I, but I think it probably benefits us more. We can Agent Venom now, but we're getting a little close here, and Cloning Vats makes things awkward. I mean, we can just keep playing this if we want to. I honestly don't think we Agent Venom. I don't know if we need to. We just kind of hope he plays in this lane. Oh, he didn't. That's okay, though. Man's playing down Quinjets, dude. He must have a plethora of six-cost cards. We did get Beast back. This is going to be a tad on the awkward side, but I think altogether, really good. We get these three back. We don't draw, but I don't care. This is so crazy. We're going to get a Beast back, too, but let's go ahead and let's get these guys back in the hand. We have all of these freaking Rocket Raccoons to play down for free. This is where something like Toxin at the end of the game would be massive here, but we're not going to be able to get him. We just get copies of these, so why not just fill that out and put a lot of power there at the same time? I mean, maybe we do that. We could also do the Silver Sables because they're not all in. Like, this seems really tough for that guy to win against, and then we do the Sage to go way over the top. I know we're filling out lanes early. I almost don't even care. Maybe he's got a Killmonger, but that hurts him so much too. Listen, I know we're not doing much Toxin stuff here, guys, but look at just how crazy these little cards go. Wow, Iron Man to boot. Okay. I mean, we don't even want to do that because this is just so much more. How crazy is this? All right, here we go. Ship it. Alrighty, so now we've got the Wiccan bounce, and we have Mojo World. We have a little Rocket Raccoon. Love all this. We'll get Iceman to kick things off for us. Right decision was made, as we can now assume he might play in here next round. Sakaar is tough, dude. Oh, but we have Wiccan now. Well, this is cool. So I think now, dude, this is just bad kind of, but I think that we have a huge chance to get the Wiccan energy now. Even if not, we still get a decent Hitmonkey. Come on, Wiccan. Yeah, massive. Huge. So we get all that Wiccan energy. I think the only bad news is we have no cards, and then also we turn our next card into a demon. So we have both those things. He just beasted his cable back, and we have our Toxin. Toxin going now is not the most ideal thing, but it's fine. And then we have the Hitmonkey too. We could. Yo, we could do this because we have. Oh my gosh. Yeah, let's do this. This is such a weird thing to do, but we're going to just do this. That was so dumb on so many levels because the Hitmonkey. I don't even know why I did that. It's okay. We did it because of that. We do have our Wiccan now that we almost have to play because we have so much extra energy. And then we'll throw down nothing. I think we just play the Wiccan right now. I think that's the play. We made such a colossal mess up. I forgot about the demon thing. I just forgot about it. Classic misplay. So we would have just turned the toxin into a demon and gotten those cards to the left back, but it is what it is. Best case scenario. Maybe not best case, but not bad. Well, let's see. Even with a colossal, turning a hit monkey that could have gone to a billion power to dust, essentially, was the brutal mistake that we think it was. I don't think it is, though, man. I don't think it is. We could do that right there. This is already feeling pretty healthy. This seems good to me. We won't play the demon down yet. We're just going to go for the middle lane and the right lane, I believe. Misery. Wow. Well, we filled that lane out, so that was a bold move. He just killed his whole deck. Okay, demon goes to a demon. And then we get all of our friends back here. Okay, we have no more cards to draw, so this confirms that we're gonna ditch this left lane. Well, there's a world where we just go crazy over there too and put four, and we have the demon here. Honestly, this is probably what we do, because we've got the left lane now stacked out with Mojo World and can't move card right. We have demon to hold at least six power over there. That goes up to 20, so that's 11. 19, so we win that lane, and we win that lane. Look at that. We won all three lanes. Beautiful with the massive mistake of what we did, too. But that's because we just had so much energy. I had 8 energy left on that round. We just didn't have enough cards. He was taking our cards, and so going up against a mill deck was not ideal, but it is what it is, and that's after the Hitmonkey mistake that I just can't wait for the comments for. Bifrost comes out. We've got Iron Man and the Hood and Wiccan, so we want to play on curve. Let's get the Hood down now. We get the demon play, all that together in one lane. Then we can balance it back, and that's a surefire way to get Wiccan down. We're going to hope we get Sable before that. This is awkward. We did, so there we go. Just get both these. Man, this is a perfect. This is a dream opening here as we beast it all back to our hand. Beast takes a Jotunheim hit, but oh well. We also, no, we don't. Okay, we don't have priority. So I guess if he were to Cosmo left, I doubt it, though. He takes our Wiccan. We take his Iron Man. Holy crap. That's a fair trade. He doesn't even have use for the Wiccan yet. And we could avoid Jotunheim for Beast if we played Falcon, but we're not going to do that. Because, you know, the Wiccan. Beautiful. So we don't draw, but we get to get the Wiccan down, which is completely fine. We have so much power to work with here. Let's play Wiccan right side. We do need to kind of hope that we start to... actually, do I mind him in the middle? Kind of foolish, but almost not. Like, I'd almost rather do this here. So we get the extra energy, we get the demon down, we have an Iron Man to go way over the top. We can Falcon these cards back. So much Iceman going on right now. Obviously getting the toxin would be insane. Oh my god. Toxin now. Iron Man here. The most perfect setup ever for our next turn. That's Iron Man. We know that.
I am Iron Man. I am Iron Man.
I'm going to go Sable, Demon, Demon. I mean, how big could he actually get here? Collector. Hood, Iceman. Iceman's a one at the end of the day, but I think that's fine. There's just no way. Oh, he goes for his own Iron Man lane. Hold the phone. It's going to be kind of close. Tim, Sable. It was closer than we would have liked, folks. It was closer than we would have liked, but we still won with flying colors. He did not go for the middle lane. We scaled up well over that. That was a tight match, and that was the definition of Wiccan's energy being insane to really spread out our last play there. Man, I like all three decks. I'm going to be honest. I like all three. They all play very different. Alrighty, so we get nothing to do turn one, but we have Iron Man, Werewolf, Black Swan, which is now unplayable, and Falcon into Wakanda. Iron Man not being available for the Agent Venom that we draw on two. It hurts a little bit, but let's go ahead and just play down Venom now. Keep in mind, he's probably going to bounce that Iceman back, so we're going to have that Iron Man almost certainly be a six cost. And a plus two. I think this is where I do like playing down this Werewolf by Night. Makes sense to me. Oh, come on. Well, we don't get our toxin because he does. He gets a copycat into cloning vats. I guess that's the only good news. And we have two of these that change locations without priority, with neither of them needing to be here. Yeah, that's awkward. All right, let's go. Let's change. I don't know. I feel like we can go well over the top in this guy, but let's just go ahead and change these locations. And then we'll call him back. Meanwhile, Werewolf by Night's going to go crazy here. There's so many locations changing. It's hilarious. Werewolf by Night always breaking the game, just completely shut off the client. He cannot do Black Panther stuff here to Wakanda, so we're feeling pretty good. We can turn things into demons. We have the Iron Man, which is massive. I might just go with this Iron Man here, dude. What are you going to do? Yeah, even though he had the better thing here with the copycat, I reckon it's going to be pretty hard for this guy to win. We'll go to cap this over the top here. Although this will move over there. So actually, let's go with this. Werewolf goes over here to this. And just end it on that. We don't want Werewolf to go another time. And that one was pretty easy. We didn't get to see our toxin again. I guess we saw our toxin through copycat over there. And 50 is pretty good, I would reckon.